to close the doors. And those that are in the lobby, if you'll go ahead and come in, we'll start our service this morning. Are y'all ready to worship this morning? Are y'all ready for a mighty move of God today? Amen. Lord, we bless your name in this place today. Lord God, we love you. We adore you. Lord, we magnify you in this place. Father, thank you for being our Savior today, Lord God. Lord, thank you for covering us with your grace and your mercy, Lord God. Father, I pray for this service right now, Lord God. Lord, move in a mighty way, Lord God. Have your way, Lord God. Let your spirit rest on us this morning. Father, we pray for the man servant that brings forth the message, Lord God. Lord, give him peace right now, Lord God. Anoint his tongue to speak right now, Lord God. Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we ask that you just fill us more with your praise in Jesus' name.
Come on, give God a hand. Give the Lord a hand clap. Yes.
Thank you, Lord God. Lord, we thank you for your blood this morning, Lord God. Lord, we thank you for your anointing that is present in this place right now, Father God. Lord, thank you for being God today, Lord God. Lord, thank you for the ultimate sacrifice, Lord God. And because of that sacrifice, Lord God, we have victory this morning, Lord
yes.
God. Lord, we have victory in every area of our lives, Lord God. Lord, thank you for the freedom right now,
yes.
Lord God. Lord, thank you for the peace that is in this place right now, Lord God. Lord, thank you, Father God, for all your many blessings in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah, Lord God. Robo bobo ye korabasha ba. Shandale sikri bobo raboska. Robo bobo ye korabasha. Robo bobo ye korabashandale sikri bobo raboska. Roska bobo ye korabashandale sikri. Robo bobo ye korababa ye korababa ye korabakana chata. Ye korabakaka ye korabashike ye korabasha ba. Shandale sikri bobo raboska. Robo bobo ye korabasi bobo raboska. It's coming down. It's coming down. It's coming down. Walls are coming down. I break the barriers right now. According to the Holy Ghost. According to the power. According to the anointing. According to the authority that is in me. I break the walls right now, Lord God. Glory, 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 glory. Thank you, Lord.
Glory, glory.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, we exalt your name, Lord God. You will take your offering. Father God, we thank you for every giver in this house, Lord God. Lord, we thank you for the seeds right now, Father God. Lord, let them go, grow, and multiply, Lord God. Let them do everything they were set out to do, Lord God. Lord, for every name seed that is being sown this morning, Lord God, I stand in firm agreement, Lord God, that you will do it right now, Father. Father, I believe you in every area of my life and the people of God right now, Father God. Lord, let these seeds bless this ministry right now. For the upbuilding of your kingdom, you may bring your offering.
You know, man, is it cold in here? All right, y'all good. All right, praise the Lord. I'm just feeling the Holy Ghost, I guess. Let me say this. You know, I used to be, let's see how that. We're the portal, and there ain't nobody. You listen, I'm going to tell you. I want you to give you something to think about. You're a gate, right? You're the gate for Jesus, heaven, to come on this earth, right? Can I tell you a secret? You're also the gates of hell. And you control what he does on this earth. Do you know that? Listen to me. There are people in here. Maybe some of you come in. Everything may be great in your life. Everything may be hunky-dory, right? There's people in here that are hurting. And you don't go to a... Listen, church is not a social club. Okay? That's the problem with what... You see, organized religion today is made a social club. Where you dress up, wear hats, all that kind of stuff. It's not. This is how many of y'all go on vacation to the emergency room? Okay? This is not a vacation. How many of you go out for a nice evening in the emergency room? This is an emergency room. This is an emergency room where there might be some surgery. And it's sometimes going to be gory and bloody, and it's going to be a little tough. But I'm going to tell you this, we got to do it. If we don't do it, I'm telling you right now, nobody else is going to do it. So you better press in. Don't worry about what people say, what they do. People in this house got delivered today, amen? So here's the problem with the camp. I'm telling you right now, let me say this first. We got a meeting today with all leaders at 4 o'clock. Remember, you're going to get to speak. We're going to listen today. What's working? What's not working? Where do you see your ministry going? And what can we do to improve? So that's some of the things you want to be ready to talk about this afternoon. Amen? Because we're going to push this thing forward. I will tell you this. We will be back in Africa in September. And so you can mark that down. Amen? The Holy Spirit gave us that. We're going to work real hard to get there. And we're just believing God. If you don't get to go this time, I promise you'll get to go again. Amen. But I want you to be much in prayer. This is a very important trip. Amen. Let me say this. I said this Wednesday night. How many of y'all were here Wednesday night? Was that amazing? It blew me away. You know, the ladder. We are the gate of heaven, right? The gates of heaven. The church. Everybody say this. Say the church is the gate of heaven. It is. We are. There ain't no other gate. There ain't no other way. And it's so sad that people today are not going to catch this, not going to get it. We're going to go through tough times. You're going to go through times where you don't feel like worshiping. You don't feel like, remember I told you, through how does a pearl get formed? Somebody tell me. Through what? Irritation and conflict, right? So you're not going to get a gate, and you're not going to get to your next destiny. Everybody wants it to be easy. Everybody wants church to be easy, life to be easy, and that would be great in a perfect world, but it ain't going to happen here, amen? So through that irritation and conflict, that's how I'm going to get to my next destiny. So I'm having a tough week. That means I'm going somewhere, amen? Because I'm going to keep worshiping, praising God no matter what, and I'm believing Him that He's going to guide me into that place I got to go. So I'm not going to get weary and well-doing. I'm not going to stay on this side of the gate I'm going to go through, right? All right, let's get ready. Ready? So what is a gate? We know the gate is a place of transition and access, right? Okay? So a gate is a place where you come and you go, right? Say amen? And when we talk about the church being the gate to heaven, we're talking about a place where the reality of His Spirit, His dominion, becomes available for all mankind. His world invades ours. Isn't that not amazing? Amen? So when His world invades mine, see, I'm the gateway to heaven, right? Heaven cannot enter earth unless it comes through me. Not Tim, Bishop Tim, but Christina, through Tim Salmon. The light of heaven cannot shine through the portal of heaven. It's got to come down. It ain't gonna come down. It's gonna come out of you. Does that make sense? Because see, the Holy Ghost has already been given. The Holy Spirit's already been given. Amen. So the gate to heaven is inside of us. Who activates the gate? You do. Guess what? I'm gonna get ahead of it. Let's just keep going. Right? I want to prove it to you. So His world invades ours. So wherever I go and wherever you go, heaven invades earth. We just sung this song, "Heaven Touching Earth." Remember a while ago? You know, some of y'all are all more watching me instead of listening to what the Word says. How does heaven touch earth? It does through us. This morning at 8 o'clock, there was nobody in this building. Was heaven touching earth? Was heaven touching earth 5 minutes, 10 minutes ago? Absolutely. Amen. People were getting delivered. Guy right here, painter guy, got delivered. Amen. Where's the other guy? Where's the other guy? I don't know where he went. Your brother was here? Where is that? Brother, where you at? Pray, how you feel, man? But at 8 o'clock this morning, you didn't feel good, did you? Did you feel good? What happened? Amen? Something happened, right? Amen? Heaven touched earth. What happened? It started flowing out of people like him, people like this guy right here, people like me, people like him, people like her. Amen? And all of a sudden, all these floods of light shining all over the place, you started getting delivered. Wow. Imagine that. Why does it not? Well, I go to church. None of this ever happens at churches I go to. Guess what? Because heaven ain't touching earth. Come on. Heaven can't get in that church because nobody will open the gate to let heaven in. They'll let the devil in. I'm going to get to that in a minute. Because the gate to hell, the gates of hell shall not prevail against me. Think about it. Let's go to Matthew 16:18, Tanya. And here's Jesus talking to Peter, right? Matthew 16:18. And I say unto thee, thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will what? Okay, not in heaven, not in a building, but upon where? Peter, right? He said, okay, and the what? The gates of hell shall not what? Prevail against it. Can you, all right? So go to the next one. And watch this. So he didn't stop. We stopped there at 18. But we got to go to 19. You've heard that scripture before, right? The gates of hell should not prevail. Watch this. Go to 19. And I will what? Give who? Me. He said, I'll give you, Peter, the keys of the kingdom of what? Nobody told you that, did they? Peter, the gates of hell shall not prevail. Oh, and let me go. See, everybody stops there. By grannies, we're on defense. We're going to stop the gates of hell. That's a problem with the church. You come here, sitting here, and you're just going to go on the defense. I'm going to pray a prayer to protect my children. I'm going to pray a prayer. I'm going to just take care of my little goose thing right here. I'm going to tell you, you're a lily-livered sissy, amen, is what you are, amen, because you ought to be on the offense instead of on the defense. Because what? Let me ask you something. How many of y'all like getting gifts? And you wrap them up real pretty, right? When I was a kid, you know, my grandmother would wrap the prettiest ribbons in the beautifulest paper that you ever seen. I couldn't even tell you which one. I couldn't even tell you none of it. I'd rip that stuff off so fast because I wanted to get to what was on the inside. Amen. And that's the way we got to be. That's the way we got to be. We got to take this pretty wrapping off the church, and we got to get to what's on the inside. So he says, I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, right? So I have the keys. And watch this. Whatsoever thou shalt bind, I got a revelation of this. I quote it all the time, but I got messed up. Man, the Holy Ghost spoke to me in the car. I was coming back from Griffin. Y'all probably didn't know the Holy Ghost existed in Griffin, but he does. I was coming back from Griffin. And God hit me so hard in the car that I thought I was going to pull over. I was going to have a wreck. I know people driving by me thought I was crazy. I had my hands out the window waving. I was waving my hand like this, like praising the Lord. God said, you're going to Africa. I said, well, praise the Lord. I ain't going. I said, it's too much. And heaven began to touch earth, amen. And the peace of God came on me so strong that I don't even think I could work the rest of the day. I don't even remember. Praise God. I went home because of the power of God. So I'm going to show you today, whatsoever is bound, you see right here, whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And I'm like, what does that mean? All right. And whatsoever it shall loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Are you with me? All right. So we'll go slow. So where is the gate to hell? I just told you. Where is it? It's in your head, right? Jesus introduced the idea of the gate of hell. He said it to Peter. Here's what the problem is. The church today is in fear of the devil. Wouldn't you agree? Everybody's like, oh, the big bad devil. Oh, everybody's scared of him, right? Amen? All right? And we worry about him. We think he's got a pitchfork. He's going to come in and blow our whole family up. Amen? But here's what the problem is. The church today is kind of, think of it this way. We're in a defense wall. Does that make sense? You ever been in a place where they shut the gate? We're in a gated community, okay? And we're trying to keep the devil out, right? Is that right? We're trying to keep the devil out of our place. But the Bible says that we should be touching the earth. We should be loosing things. Whatever's in heaven, amen, should be loosed on this earth, amen. Who's going to loose heaven and earth? Us, me and you. So it's bound right now in heaven, amen. We got to loose it in earth. You understand what I'm talking about? Whatsoever's bound in heaven has got to be loosed on earth. I'll show you in a minute. I'll get to it. You'll see it. So we're kind of scared, and we're doing nothing but hiding. That's where the church is today. That's why you get scared when you feel the Spirit of God, amen, because the devil freaks out. He's like, oh, my God. You know, you start going, see what these guys did. They come up here and pray. When I try to get you to move your hands or do anything, that means you're going on the offense instead of the defense, right? What does offense mean? You're trying to score, right? So we should take it, when you come in here and you start worshiping and you start being that portal of light, like we were praying this morning and the glory of God was just spouting out all over everybody, man. And Terry was doing her thing, you know what I mean? Praise God. And you can feel the earth shaking, amen. We became a portal for heaven, amen. And we released whatever God was doing in the heavens, amen, into this building here today. Did we not? Because it was inside of us. So whatever we release, amen, is healing in heaven? Should it be released on earth? Power, dominion is in heaven. Should it be released on earth? How is it going to get released? Is Jesus? I told somebody one day, I used to say, God ain't going to throw no lightning bolt at you anymore. But guess what? God said, you know what? You say that all the time, but you got the lightning bolts. I said, oh my Lord. You can stand there and go, hey lady. Lady, what's your gale, right? yell, pray, pow, pow, pow. I was throwing darts at you. I was like Spider-Man or somebody else, whatever, shooting him light. Pow, 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 pow. You have to touch her, amen. Because whatsoever is bound on earth, amen, is bound in heaven. So the problem is that we wonder why we don't see healing. We don't see dominion on the earth, amen, but it's free in heaven. If you expect to be healed in heaven, why can't you be healed here? If you expect to have streets of gold and pearly gates, why can't you have them here? It'll be peaceful, joy, no devil. Well, why do you tolerate the devil here? Amen? You become what you talk. Oh, I've had bad luck. It's because you talk about it all the time. You know what? I'm going to get to this in a minute. When you start speaking negative and opening your mind to negative things, you open the gates of hell and you know how I was talking about the angels ascending and descending? The devil's got the same ones. He's got a ladder coming up, and he's watching you, and he has no access into the earth till you come in agreement with what he says. Oh, the devil's on me. Well, you gave him access. You came in agreement with the devil, and you opened up the gates of hell, and the gates of hell are prevailing against you. Come on, I'm telling you. You think I'm lying? I'm telling you right now. The hell you're going through in earth right now is because you agreed with Satan himself and allowed him to come in. I'll show it. I'll prove it to you. So watch this. Jesus wants to do the very opposite. He said the gates of hell shall not prevail, right? Has it ever occurred that we are on the offense, that we should be on the offense and not on the defense, right? We're not coming here, people say, Bishop, you should wait till the end of the service and pray for everybody. Oh, hush. We got visitors here today and you may offend them. Well, somebody better. Offense sounds like offense. And I'm not going to sit here and let the devil kill that man. I'm not going to sit here and let the devil torment that guy. I'm not going to sit here and let the devil take rampant over your house. I'm not going to. What? I'm going to stand for God. God's going to say, you let the devil run rampant over them people. Because you sat still because you want to be dignified. You want to be in that. You want to just be in your little fence, little church, and you don't want to do nothing. Now I'm going to go on the offense. I'm going to jump on a chair, and I'm going to tell the devil to get back to where he came from. Amen. And I'm not scared of him, amen? And he don't like me, I know it. I know that, amen? But I don't care. I'm going to keep loosing stuff. The more I loose on this earth that's in heaven, the more the devil can't mess with me. That makes sense. And guess what? The more that you open up, the more gates that you open up for heaven to come into the earth, the devil, the gates of hell will begin to shut in your life. You'll start shutting them down. I'll show you. So, the powers that have been set up against the gates all over the earth. See the devil, watch this. The devil, the gate of hell is in a person, right? Is it not? Yes. So the devil has set up gates of hell all around you to stop you from reaching your destiny. He has surrounded you, and now you don't see a way of escape. Wow. Y'all didn't catch that, did you? So what does that mean, Miss Gwen? He surrounded you with some negative, goofy people in your life that got the gates of hell open, amen. And they're tormenting you, and you say, well, I gotta be their friend. No, you don't. You better start shutting the gates of hell. And when you start shutting the gates of hell, you start shutting people out of your life that don't need to be in there anymore. And my God, wait, look at this thing. Praise the Lord, y'all find this out. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I like this thing. I don't even know how to wear it. Praise the Lord. I'm going to be like the rabbi. Oh, shot that old boy, Cordy. I didn't put that there. I don't know where it came from. So, here's the thing. We're advancing, right? Oh, I'll be going hot already. Praise the Lord. We're advancing and winning, right? So, we are advancing and we're winning, right? So, Jesus promised that in the end, no gate of hell will stand against us, right? So what are you afraid of? Oh, I got depression. Okay, guess what? Shut the door. Shut the door to the devil and open up the gate. Through irritation and conflict, let that depression take you to your next destiny. The problem is you stay in it. I'm going to stay in my addiction right here, praise the Lord. Because you stay right on them goofy people that feed you the addiction. Right? Amen? I'm going to stay sick. I'm going to stay. My body's going to stay afflicted. It's because you listen to what everybody else says instead of what the Word says. And when you come in agreement with the Word, you'll open up the gates of heaven, and heaven will begin to flow out of you, right? So, where are the gates of hell? Where does the devil reign in power? Somebody tell me. In your mind. Remember, the mind is the gatekeeper of the kingdom of God, is it not? It's a place of access, okay? It's a place of access, transition, and of power. You got to release that power. You got to release that anointing, amen? People are dying and going to hell every day because they don't understand this. And they don't stay in the flow, but, and they shut the door to what we're trying to do here because they never experience this. You go to church today, I'm telling you right now, there's a great chance you're not going to experience heaven. Does that make sense? You go to somebody's house today, maybe they say they're a Christian, amen? There's a great chance you're not going to experience heaven in that house. How many people know people that are say they're born again, but you never see heaven in them, right? Right? But here it is. It makes sense that the gates of hell are also set up in people's minds. Jesus said this in Matthew 16, 21 and 23. Watch this. I want you to get this because if you can start controlling this, you remember we talked about last year, earlier in the year, mastering the silence, if we can start controlling our thoughts, and we can start shutting down the things. So when it rises up, you got to let the gate of heaven, you got to let the portals of heaven open up and shut that gate of hell, amen, so that the enemy can't have dominion in your life. And those people that are around you that are feeding you the same old stuff, you got to shut it down. You have the power to do that. The only person that can control your mind is, amen, oh, I'm freaking out of here. It's crazy in this place. First time I've ever been here, I'm out of here. Amen. No, you got to start. You got to just ride it out and say, hey, you know what? Let me see. How do I get to my next destiny? How do I get to my next place? Things haven't been working in my life really good. So, you know what? I'm going to give it a shot. I'll tell you, I tried all the church stuff. I tried all this, you know, crying until you slung snot, praying until you got an answer. I tried all that stuff. It didn't work. So I began to access the power of God in my own life. And I began to discover who I was in Christ. And I said, devil, no more will I tolerate you. You're not going to mess with my life. You're not going to mess with my marriage. You're not going to mess with my finances. You're not going to mess with my church. You're not going to mess with my children. You're not going to mess with my job. You're not going to mess with my friends. Boom. What you tolerate in your head is what you become. Do you understand me? You know what? There's a lot of you in here that you're the portal for the devil into this earth. Oh, let me say this. Y'all ain't going to get mad at me, are you? The reason some of your families are so messed up is because you are the gate of hell and you're allowing hell to come into your family. And you don't know how to shut it. Get mad. That's okay. But wouldn't it be a lot nicer to be the gate to heaven and start letting the love flow? Amen. What? Why don't you tolerate that stuff? Why don't you tolerate it? I'll tell you what. I let my light be so bright that it would shine, it would knock the devil out. Amen. I don't care if it's my husband. I don't care who it is. I don't care if it's your children. Amen. You should open the gate of heaven. Amen. And say, I will not tolerate no more negativity. Because negativity is depression. Depression is fear. And fear is from the pits of hell. So if you got fear in your life, you got a gate of hell open somewhere. If you got depression, gate of hell. You don't like people, gate of hell. You got to love everybody. I like 99%. No. You got a gate, you got to shut. And the only way that thing has that hate and all that stuff has access is through you. It ain't through me. People always, you know, Pastor Chris the other day, oh, I ain't going there no more. Bishop don't feed me no more. Bye. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Matthew 16, 21 says this. You got it? You'll put it up. She probably had it up already. From that time forth began Jesus to show unto his disciples how that he must go unto Jerusalem and suffer many things of the elders and chief priests and scribes and be killed and be raised again on the third day. Go to 22. You see that? Watch. 22. Then Peter took him and began to rebuke him. Go back. 22. I didn't get done. Y'all are quick today. Praise the Lord. Amen. Peter took him and began to rebuke him, saying, be it far from thee, Lord. This shall not be unto thee. Now go watch this. Watch what Jesus said. But he turned and he said unto Peter, get thee behind who? Peter had opened the door to the devil. He'd opened the gate of hell. Hey, watch, I'll show you. He didn't what? Satan, he said, Satan, thou art an offense unto me, for thou savorest not the things that be of God, but those things that be of men. You see that? You see that? So watch this. He didn't say, Peter, you're a devil worshiper. He didn't say your mind is full of demonic actions or practices. He said, Your mind is filled with the things of man. You know what's wrong with all you people? Not all you people. Some of you people. That your head is filled with the things of man. And who is that a? Who is? I'm going to tell you. If you got things filled in your head that are a man, like, oh, I'm worried about what college my kid. I don't care what college my kids go to. Because God's got it all worried out. He's all going, oh, Bishop, I can't believe you said that. Well, why am I to worry? It's not up to me to get in college. It's up to my kids to get in college, right? Yeah. Why are you going to worry about that? So, Bishop, you should be worried about it. I'm not worried about anything. Amen? Because the Bible says that we pray, we believe, and then we shall have it, right? So we pray. I understand sometimes it's a transformation. It takes time. But watch this. But those things that be of men. If you got the mind of a man and you try to reason like a man and you try to reason the way the world reasons, amen, that's of the devil. And it's a gate of hell. You cannot think carnal and act carnal and expect to reap spiritual. Does that make sense? Things ain't working. I don't feel it. You don't feel it because you got a gate of hell open in your life. I feel it. Y'all think I feel it? Feel him? Huh? I feel him. I say every day, shut that roll, shut that. I feel him every day. He's in there. I just pray in tongues just to know he's there. Amen. Huh, right? You hear Miss Quinn? Hey! She's hollering, yelling, whatever she's doing. I don't know. Heaven. I'm not telling you we don't have tough days, but what do? We shout it out. You gotta quit it. Oh, you think I get up every day wanting to pray? You think I get up every day wanting to preach? You think I came here this morning? Hey, I woke up this morning, I gotta go to prayer. I'm going to prayer, you know. And you push yourself, what happens, man? You change the atmosphere. You start shutting the gate, you shut all the gates of hell. You should come, man, y'all should have came here throwing yourself against the wall. Y'all should have been running. I should have been directing traffic up here. Instead of being me and Miss Gwen, the only ones. We're going, hey, hallelujah. But man, when you got heaven, y'all always say, how many of y'all said this? Man, when I get to heaven, I'm going to run and shout and jump. No, you ain't. No, you ain't, because you don't run, shout, and jump here. Amen? You got it bound up in here. I'm going to praise. I'm going to go to the feet of Jesus and worship. Oh, hush. You don't even do it here. You're going to have to get past me. I get first access because he goes, hey, you've been faithful, brother. Come on, get up here. You messed up. Hey, get on up here. Amen. And that's the way it is. If you got access, why wouldn't you use access? If I got the key, why don't I use the key? Why I got to kick the door in when I got the key? That makes sense? So he didn't say, he said, your mind is filled with the things of man. Now listen, I want you to get this. The devil himself, Satan, has no power. Was he stripped? Would y'all all agree with that? Well, why don't we run around telling him how powerful the devil is? He is a worthy adversary. You know why he's worthy? Because you made him worthy. You know why he's a tough adversary in your life? I've been through this. Listen, I'm preaching to the choir here. Amen. I've been through it as a pastor. I've been through it as a believer. Amen. But you know why? You know why it is? Because he's empowered through our human agreement. How many times you said, I just give up? Well, he's like, boys, come on. She just opened the door for us to come in. She gave up. Did Jesus give up when he walked on the Via Dolorosa to Calvary? No, he did not give up. Amen. He went all the way. He stood in agreement. So, and watch this. I'm going to blow your head off. You're not going to like this. Blow your mind up. That's why I shouldn't say that. It sounded bad, didn't it? So the devil's empowered through our agreement. Would you agree? When somebody says when you're not worth nothing, you go, I must not be worth nothing. You agree with it. You let him come in, and you become nothing. I'm not feeling it. You agree with the devil, and you let him come in. Does Jesus feel it? I feel it. Do you feel it when you came in here? Christine, when you first walked through these doors, there wasn't nothing, was there? Except what's in you. But when it began to manifest, the Holy Spirit, we began to feel it together, right? Does that make sense? So it's the same thing. The gate, that's the gate where Satan will release his destruction in your mind, right? When you agree with him, that's where he releases his destruction in your mind. And not only that, but here's the thing. I figured this out. I was like, how if a mother does it affect her kids? I was like, if a dad does it, because people say, oh, I'm not hurting nobody but myself. Oh, that's a lie. Oh, that is a lie. Once we open the gates of hell, all them demonic beings, you know, I don't believe in that stuff. You better start believing, amen. When you open the door to the devil, he runs rampant in your children's life also, amen. I'm going to tell you, we as parents, I'm going to tell you, if you ain't never worshiped before, you ought to worship today. A lot of kids are messed up because their family did not, their mom and dad did not worship the Lord. They opened the gate of hell in their children's life that will affect generations. Then their children don't know. They hear negativity, depression, oppression, all this kind of junk. Then they spread it to their children. What's the devil doing? Through the power of agreement, he says. We could shut the devil down in the earth today if everybody would take this message to heart. You could shut generations of devils down in your family if you would just shut your mouth, probably. I didn't want to say that. Your gate. Watch it. I've said this before, so God, you don't get mad. Don't think I'm picking on you. To say I am only, how many of y'all said I'm only human? We've all said it. Come on. I make mistakes. If you said it, I said it. I'm only human. You know what that means? I'm only satanic. I'm not human no more. I'm supernatural. Because when I accepted Jesus Christ as my personal Savior, I shed my human nature and picked up the godly nature. Don't ever call, oh, he's just human. He makes me. Don't lay that on me, brother. I ain't never saying it again. And don't you ever, you people, I could take four pennies and make $4 million. God blesses you with four pennies, take four pennies, shake them up, throw them in the offering plate, and watch it manifest. Whoa! I got to be rich to tithe. No, you ain't going to get it. Hey, you got to be poor to get I ain't going to say it. You people got the gates shut in. You know why their finances are jacked up? Because they let the gates of hell come against them. I can buy what I want when I want. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Are you rich? I got faith. I go wherever I want to go. Well, you mean you can afford that? Yeah, absolutely. You may not choose not to go do something, but don't say you can't, because that's a human characteristic. That's carnal thinking. Oh, my kids are just never going to get a job. Thank you, Mother, Father, for releasing hell against your kid. My kids act goofy, but we try to be positive. One of them in college, one of them there. You know, Tyler's called me a few weeks ago. You know, he got this money promise year about 3 or 4 months ago, 5 months ago, wasn't it, Stacy? And he called me and goes, this ain't coming. I said, bro, what's your faith? I didn't get in all negativity with him. I said, you got to have faith. I said, well, that's all right, cool. I said, if it don't work, I said, you know what? Hey, you know, you just keep sitting there. Just get your job, whatever. Just trust God. I believe God. It's coming. Blah, 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 blah. I never got negative. One time, he would call. He'd get all depressed. He calls mom and get all depressed. You know what? Not once did I ever hear her get negative. Not once did we ever get negative with him on the phone. And we prayed for him now. I ain't going to lie. We did. Me and her prayed. Said, God, you know, you said it. You did. How many times we say, God, you said he was getting that scholarship, and God, it ain't came yet. So we're believing. We didn't tell Tyler. We didn't go, oh, it just, you know, that government's a bunch of, oh, terror. No, we didn't put the gate of hell in his life. You know what? 3 weeks ago, he got every bit of the money and plus some. My God's able to give you thousands of dollars when you didn't know it was coming. I'm telling you. But you know what God showed me? Had me and her got negative. So move on home. Just move home. Boom. You're done, man. You know, God is just not answered our prayer. Tyler would be back at home. He'd be at Chick-fil-A with Michaela working, flipping chicken burgers, whatever. Amen. But how dare you release hell in your children? If you want to be in hell, just sit there and don't say nothing. How dare you speak against our church? Don't release no day. Hey, don't, you know what? When you speak against me, you speak against the ministry. Amen. And you open a gate of hell against us, and that takes me longer to defend it. I got to go whoop him so I can get to where I need to go. I'm tired of fighting your battles, so I got to go get some other ones. Amen. Amen. So if I can teach you not only that we're the access point to the kingdom of God, and there ain't no angel coming to this earth, devil or demonic or heavenly, unless you release them. I'm having bad luck. Well, it's your fault. I don't feel good. It's your fault, Josh. Don't let the devil see you sweat. You don't feel good? Don't say it. Because when you say, I don't feel good, you open the gate of hell to come against you. You'll take a sniffle and make it a full-blown flu before you know it. Oh, I got a lump. It must be cancer. Now I got a lump. You know what? I must hate someone to a degree. Whatever. You know what I'm saying? No, you don't accept it. You see what I'm saying? Don't ever open up a gate that can come against you, right? Because then once you open it up, you got to be the one that shuts it. You got to be the one that combats against it. So the more less you open, the less you got to shut. Does that make sense? So don't say, to say I'm only human is to say I'm only satanic. Humanity, watch this. Hashtag it. I don't care. People get mad. They don't like me anyway, so what does it matter? I know the devil don't like me. He don't want you to know this. And I'm going to tell you, Terry, you said, like, I'm teaching some good stuff here. And some of y'all just blowing it off like this is normal. You know, let's go color the ark and talk about two animals getting on the boat. Amen? I ain't worried about no elephant. I'm not worried about none of that stuff. Somebody asked me one day, what about the dinosaurs on the ark? I don't want to hear none of that stuff. And hush. I don't know, but ask God when you get to heaven. They always ask you about the dinosaurs. You ever do that? You shut that door. That's demonic, right? Humanity without Jesus at the center. Listen to this. Humanity, our daily life, my daily life, watch this. Without Jesus at the center is satanic in nature. We've been born again, filled with the Holy Spirit, and give them the Spirit of the living God. Why do we not use it? Why do we not use those gates instead of pity party devil gates? Use these gates to get me to us to our next destiny. Soar our kids into a new destiny. Soar our husband and wife into a new destiny. Why do we tolerate? I'm going to tell you, when you start speaking right and your light starts hitting them long enough, they'll start seeing the light. But when you agree with their human nature, your kids start whining, and you agree with their human nature, then you open a portal of hell against your kids. When your husband or your wife, amen, starts complaining, amen, and whining, and negativity, and you go in agreement with them, you go along with them, you open up a portal of hell in your family. Why do marriages get messed up? Oh, there it is right there. Amen. Why the finances get messed up? Right there. You get one bill you can't pay. You quit trusting God when you got one bill you can't pay. Who cares? You know what? I'll be somebody mad one day. They say, I can't pay my house payment. I said, you tithe? Why can't he pay my house payment? How can I tithe? I said, well, you'll never pay your house payment. People quit asking me about money. Pastor Chris, they don't ask him either. But you go talk to a lot of the seed. You see, you open doors. You know, we lose. When you're born again, see, saying I'm only human and I ain't feeling it and it ain't with me no more, that's a cop-out. Amen? That you're trying to put that on somebody else, but in actuality, it's on you. That makes sense? So, watch this. When you're born again, filled with the Holy Ghost, you no longer have the right to say I'm human. Because if you say it and you're born again, filled with the Holy Ghost, then somewhere there's a lie. Are you born again, filled with the Holy Ghost, filled with power, and do with power, have dominion over all the powers? You have dominion over sickness, pain. You have dominion over finance. You had dominion even over the way you feel. You can, you know what? You don't ever have to feel unspiritual. You can always, my God, hi. Pastor Chris said the other day, he didn't say it this way, but I'm going to tell you what he was saying. Even if you don't feel like it, fake it. Hey! Because God's going to get tired of it, and you finally, it'll start popping out of you again. That's fine. I said it, yeah. Y'all lying if you said you ain't coming here and had to shake yourself up. You so wore out, you didn't feel like where you went. Hey! Ha! And then all of a sudden you went, something snapped. You went, whoa! It's happened to me. I've come here like, I'm tired tonight. I'm going to sit over here and chill out. And I'm like, praise the Lord. And it kicks in overdrive. I'm like, next thing I find myself doing, you know, I wave my arm, kick my foot, something kind of funny, you know. It kicks in. You know, you got to push yourself, right? You got to get on the bike and pedal. And sometimes you don't want to do it, but you got to do it. All right, I got a few minutes. It's 12 o'clock. I'm almost done. Is this helping you? So you can't say that no more, right? Don't say it. Do you know why? Me and you are much more than that. In fact, Paul rebuked the church at Corinth for behaving like men, right? 2 Corinthians 10 and 5 says this. Pull it up. And it confirms the gates of hell. You see it? Y'all know this verse very well. We talk about it in Bible college all the time. We can't behave like we used to. We can't think the way we used to. We can't act the way we used to. You know, if you want to be carnal, you should stay carnal. If you want to stay negative, stay negative. Devil's negative. Negativity has ruined so many lives. Negative. You know what? I'm going to tell you. I saw Pastor Jay says, you know why these young people are dying? You know why all these people are dying in their 40s and 50s? You know, and God help, you know, James' situation. They went to see his brother. But so many people are dying now. Do you know why? They have spoke this their death into existence. By the what we hear on TV and the negatives. See, our society, remember I told you, I'm going to tell you, how many young people are here for the first time? Anybody here? All right, cool. Watch this. When you got sick, when we get sick as kids, what does mom and daddy do for us? I've told you all this before. They reward us for being sick. Right? Oh, little Susie, you're sick. Let me buy you a teddy bear. So little Susie, listen, it's devil, demonic. Look, the devil's like, no. You should walk in the room and say, hey, you don't feel well? You're healed in the name of Jesus. And by the way, I'm going to tell you how to get a kid healed real quick now. This is back in my day. It was TV. You go in there and say, hey, give me your cell phone, Miss Susie. Cell phone, where's the remote? Let me take that. Watch how fast they get healed. They won't need a taco. They won't need a teddy bear. They won't need nothing. They'll mysteriously be healed. Even if they were sick, they'll be healed because they want that cell phone back, right? You understand what I'm talking about? So we've created a society in the church. Preachers have created a society of people saying, you're only human. No, if you mess up, I'm going to forgive you and pull you out of the ditch. But listen, don't be putting human characteristics on something. You can't lay that on a heavenly us anymore. We're spiritual, right? Amen. Filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. We don't have human characteristics. We have God characteristics. Does that make sense? So get out of it. Pastor Chris said the church is in a funky state. It is. Get out of this junk you're in. Get motivated. The gate of hell is in our minds. Anytime we agree with the enemy. We empower him anytime we agree with man-centered, carnal wisdom that does not agree with the Word of God. That makes sense? Amen? Don't do it, even if you feel like it. You empower demonic forces. You. You know what? You could be the reason. You could be the reason. And you may not even see this. And you probably are the reason for everything, the troubles going around your family. You know why no job ever works out for you? Because you're the problem. You know why relationships never work? You're the problem. You can't take, I told somebody this the other day, you can't take the same old baggage into a new day. Amen. What the baggage you brought yesterday to what you felt yesterday, you can't bring into today. Today's a new day. Amen. And people do it all the time. They take a bad relationship, they go right back into the same old bad relationship. And they wonder why, and they blame God, and they blame Bishop. Bishop, it never works out. It's because you're stupid. I'm sorry. I promise I won't say it no more. You goofy people. Do not come ask me for advice. If you make them, what did Jesus tell the woman caught in adultery? Then why you people do you keep doing the same old stupid stuff over and over again? Why do you keep saying the same thing? You keep opening up more gates of hell in your life, and you want, and all you're doing is opening up more headaches for you. Let me tell you, Minister Gwynn, I'm all about reducing headaches. I'm all about reducing stress in my life. I'm all about reducing people irritate me. You understand? I don't want none of it. I got God, Jesus. I talk to Stacey all the time. I got Jesus and you. Hallelujah. My kid, you know, it all flows from there, right? Amen. I'm not worried about the other stuff. Amen. If I made a mistake yesterday, I certainly ain't going to make that one again. Amen. Because that'll open up a gate of hell. And can I tell you something? The Bible says, watch this. When you've been, all right, you shut the door to hell. God sets you free. A lot of y'all been set free from bad relationships, bad drugs, bad everything, right? Listen to me well. You shut that gate and you open up the gate of heaven and you start flowing out. If you shut that gate to heaven and you open the gate that was there before, the Bible says seven more gates will open up, more wicked than the first, and you just open up more hell on yourself than you can't handle it. I don't want to do, and then I don't want to deal with it, and I promise you this, nobody around you wants to deal with it. I'm serious. Go read it. The Bible said the woman is swept and garnished, and it got clean, and then she opened the door again, and seven more spirits, more wicked than the first, came in and destroyed it. That's something to think about. So before you go in that next relationship, remember how bad the first one was? And you get somebody just like the other one, they're going to be seven times worse. Say hallelujah. I'm telling you. I scared you there, didn't I? You had a bad problem. You had a bad addiction. Open up the doors of hell again. You'll have a seven more time problem. That's why people that are in bad relationships and get into another one, it's worse. Then they got 17 babies they got to pay by four different ladies. And they might as well go ahead and retire because they ain't never going to make no money. I'm trying to tell you people how to shut the door to the devil in your life. You better listen. Get mad. I don't care. Well, I care. Jesus said, cast your cares. So if you're mad, take it up with him because he gave me this, right? When you agree with him and you let this happen, you empower the devil and his forces to become a gate in your life. And he sits there and he releases power. Remember how I talked about Jacob's ladder? The devil has the same ladder. And his same access point is through you. And the devils, they're sent on assignment, they ascend and descend. Just like the ones from heaven ascend and descend. Are you with me? Study it. I just showed you. That's what Jesus was talking about with Peter right there. He said, you got to shut the door. And I'm going to tell you, it's a little scary, isn't it? But it's the truth. You know what I'm talking about? Seven more times worse. So you better make sure. I tell somebody all the time. They ask me. I said, you need to go find somebody. You know, let's say you had somebody that was maybe not faithful the whole time. Go find you somebody that ain't never been married. Right? Go find you somebody. I told somebody, they may not be the prettiest. The package may not look really as good as you want it to. But look on the inside. It ain't about what's on the outside. Come on, somebody. Look, Pastor Stacy took me. Amen. Thank God. She looked inside my blue eyes and said, hey, something better in there. I'm still amazed she took me, man. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm glad I was nice to her. Amen. And she's been awesome for me. Amen. And that's what it takes. That's what it's going to take in your life. You understand what I'm saying? You know, I'm going to tell you this. Listen to me good. I don't know why I'm on this. It ain't going to be the first one that comes in the door. It's going to be the one that you don't need. I was like, she's too young for me. I started reasoning in my head. And then the mom and them ain't going to let me go out with her and stuff like that. I was like, man, you know what? But I said, you know what? I'm going to stick. Something in my spirit. I will stick with it. And it's not what you think sometimes. And next thing you know, all of a sudden the power of God hits it and it's the right thing. Right? And you think, oh, nobody's ever going to have me. You know why? Because you open up the gate of hell in your life against it. And the devil's fighting. Every good man that comes or woman comes in your life, the devil's fighting against. Because you say, I'm never going to get a good man or a woman. Yeah, you just open hell against it. So you got all the devils in hell fighting you against getting the right person in your life. And do you see what I'm saying? I'm telling you, I'm preaching better than y'all shouting, but that's okay. This helped me. Is this helping y'all? You got to shut the door, man. Come on. So what do we do? Here it is. I'm almost done. I'm going to get you to Moe's or wherever you got to go. So what do we do? Everybody say, what do we do? Here it is. Our goal, our deal is to agree with heaven all the time. I don't feel good. Don't say it. Don't let the devil see you sweat. To let our minds be the gate of heaven where angels ascend and descend freely on assignment from God. So, let's go slow. If I got a gate where God can flow in and out, even if I'm asleep, angels are ascending. They descend to do a goal, and then they ascend when they're finished. If I got the gate shut, they can't ascend or descend. They can't do nothing. Are you with me? All right, and I will get in Matthew 16:19 says this. I'm going to read it again. Watch this, and I'll show you. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Thank you, Jesus. And whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. So whatever we bind has already been bound. You see it? Watch this. Our task is to see what's bound up there. You see, up in heaven, right? And bind it down here. In heaven, we don't have no sickness, no stress, no pain, nothing like that. It's all peace, love, and joy. So guess what? Amen. We're to release that on the earth, right? Is sickness and pain up there in heaven? So we're to bind it on the earth. Are you with me? Depression, human nature, is that going to be in heaven? So we're to bind it here, right? Bad thoughts, bad words, are they going to be in heaven? So we should bind them on earth. So you see what I'm talking about? You get it? You understand what I'm talking about? Whatsoever we need to bind, we don't want to bring that to our heavenly realm. See, here's the problem. Y'all trying to be a spiritual heavenly creature and still toy with earthly human nature things that have no dominion over you. Does that make sense? Bad relationships, bad talk, potty mouth, depression, oppression, addictions, all that stuff. They ain't none of that going to be in heaven. So won't you bind it on earth? Right? You know what he says? So whatever's free in heaven needs to be set free and released here. Right? I put a hashtag on this. I don't even tweet. But I just thought I'd give you something. Right, rewrite this down. We are the gateway people. We are to be a gateway people for the free flow of heaven realities in this planet. We are to be a gateway people for the free flow of heaven, heavenly realities into this planet. Is that not true? How do you know what is bound and loosed in heaven? Who tells us what heaven looks like? The only way to know is to be in tune with the Holy Spirit and have a revelation of what's happening there. You understand? There ain't no bad relationships in heaven. There ain't no depression there. There ain't no unforgiveness there. So when I get a vision of what's going on there, I can bring it here. I don't have to stress out about my job because Jesus is God. Oh, y'all might be sold. Praise the Lord. Maybe the next owner will be better than this one. Hallelujah, I believe you will. But God's got this. Oh, you need $2,500 to go to Africa. All right, praise the Lord. You know, I look at my bank account, it says no, but Jesus says yes. That's human. God said go, so who am I to tell him I can't go? Oh. Right? Does that make sense? Oh, you ain't nothing. No, I am somebody according to God. Oh, I rebuke you because you wear a patch. You wear a patch. You can't be, no, I know who I am in Christ. Praise the Lord. You rebuke me all day you want. Amen. In fact, I bind you up because you ain't going to be in heaven with me. Because people that don't love and they hate, especially people with believers, because you know what? People don't look like you, smell like you, act like you, and you condemn them and you judge them. Amen. Praise God. Ain't you glad that they ain't going to be in heaven like that, right? So you can rebuke them and bind them up. Amen. Don't tolerate them. I'm almost done. I really am. The only way to know to be is to be in tune with the Holy Spirit. Have a revelation of what's happening there. God's always wanted to release His truth to His people. You understand that? He wants to release His truth. He always wants to do that. Backed by the word of things that are found in heaven but not in earth. But nobody asked. Nobody said. Nobody wants Him to, right? So, He wants things that are in heaven that no one has ever experienced to be released here so we can glory in these heavenly lifestyles, right? He don't want people to be sick. In John 3 and 12, He said, "If I have told you earthly things and you believe not, how shall you believe if I tell you heavenly things?" Listen, did you catch that? Did y'all catch that? Please listen to me. Why? You know why you didn't experience in heaven? Because He said you won't believe it. He said, "You got all these gates of hell open to your life. How am I going to speak to you? You ain't going to believe it. If I dropped in with scars in my hand, you still wouldn't believe me." So He's like, "Hey, I told you earthly things, okay, and you believe not. So why in the world are you going to believe heavenly things if I tell you? Because you ain't going to believe it either." That's what He said. So that's why you don't experience it. Because of your negativity, the way you speak, the way you say things, the way you do things, the way you create your atmosphere. He was expressing His desire to reveal things to us about what's happening in the spiritual realm that have nothing to do with the earthly picture. Are you with me? Does that make sense? He's trying to reveal things to you, but dummy, you got to open your ears. You got to open your spirit. Amen? Because the things you say and do have nothing to do with the heavenly picture. Does that make sense? The more of heaven that we release on earth will result in the church seeing a revelation like we've never known. But if we don't release it, we're right here. Tell me the earthly word. Tell me the earthly word. Bible, the people say, "I'm broke. My checkbook says I'm broke." That's earthly things, right? He said, "You believe me now. How shall you believe if I tell you heavenly things?" So that's why you still see it. When we see this, when this happens, the church see a revelation like we never. When this happens, we'll start seeing signs, wonders, miracles, and power, amazing revelation. And we'll begin to fulfill our destiny, right, of being the house of God, the gate of heaven, and in do so, we will shut the gates of hell in our life. How about that? Amen? You got to be que sera, sera. Things don't bother me no more. Praise God, I'm free. So the things I left here, I will not pick up again because I'm a believer. Hey, guy, you're a believer, right? Born again, right? Brought baggage in here, right? How'd you get it out? You shouted it out, right? Start shutting gates, right? Start shutting doors. You know exactly every door in your life that was coming against you, right? And what did I tell you? Shut them down, right? Shut every single gate down. Because you know what? Praise God. You can't go in the... How old are you? So you're my age, right? Give or take. I'm a little bit older than you, but praise the Lord. I wish I was 47, but yeah, praise the Lord. I feel 42.
39, Jack didn't hold it.
But you're too young... Would y'all agree he's too young to die now?
Amen.
Okay. So you don't want to die, right? Amen. You want to live. And you, this your girlfriend? Huh? Praise the Lord. We don't know yet, but you may have a life together, right? Praise the Lord, right? Amen. God's will is up to you. His will is up to you. Y'all open up the gates of heaven. Don't bring the same baggage y'all both have. I'm giving marital counseling right here in my message. Praise the Lord. So... That guy's laughing. You want something too? I'll help you out. Hallelujah. But when you start shutting them doors of hell in your relationship, you'll start seeing, man, oh my God, this is better than I thought it was. You know what I'm saying? And then there's not so much baggage. When you go into it, it's like, man, we ain't got to worry about money. We got to worry about the stuff we used to do because we've been set free. And we're going to go through some things, but guess what? That's just a gateway to get to my next destiny, praise God. Hallelujah. I'm not going back to where I was. No, devil. No. He'll yell at you from behind the door. Oh, you did this back in 1972. He's behind the door. Hey, you remember what you did in 1972? Yeah, I sure do. You stay back there. This is 2015. Hallelujah. Oh. You did this last Saturday night. Today's Sunday, praise God. I ain't the same as I was Saturday night. I shut the door on you, devil. He hates it. Y'all heard a story about the three, is it three little pigs? Were they huff and puff? Huh? Amen. I'm messing with. How many of y'all remember Cheech and Chong? policeman's knocking on the window, and he goes, I hear you knocking, but you're not coming in. That's a bad example, but let me get back to the three little pigs. I had a flashback. I'm sorry. Come on. It was 1972. Let's leave that word. But I hear him. Don't y'all hear him? How many people are feeling really good? I feel good about myself right now. You? I hear him huffing and puffing. He never stops. He huffs, puffs, he kicks the door. I hear him beating on the door. I hear him banging on all them doors I shut over the years. He's beating on that door. I ain't open it. I will not open it. I don't care. He may try to tell you behind the door, he's somebody he ain't. You know who's behind that door, number two. This ain't like let's make a deal, but I'm going way back. You know who's behind that door. Don't open that door and release him back into your life. I'm done. Praise the Lord. Come on, get us home. I mean, I could go all day. Could go all day. But I want you to get this because so many people today don't see themselves in a new place with Christ. And they say, well, I'm going through trouble. I'm going through pain. Through what you went through today, this guy right here, what's his name? Dale, that's right. Through what Dale went through today, Dale's going to be able to excel to that next place, right? You know what? I'm going to tell you, I like this guy. You mind if I share something? He comes to my office, he goes, I'm ready. I'm like, all right, praise the Lord. He goes, I'm ready. I was all right, praise the Lord. I'm ready to get rid of it all. I said, all right, praise the Lord. You know what? He came in wanting. He came in seeking. And you did exactly that, right? So what you got to do, you got to be determined in your spirit. You got to be determined in your life right now. Those things that are bothering you, you've been a bored Christian long enough. There's nothing greater than a bored, dry, toast Christian can feel the Holy Ghost and explode. I love that. You make everybody else get excited. So, come on, Negative Nelly. Faithless Freddy, come on. Come on to the other side. Get set free. Come pray in the Holy Ghost. Shout like that God did. Shout, you'll start seeing doors open for you. So while we sing, stand to your feet.